Hi, I'm Matt Binneker, the Director of Clinical Virology and Vice Chair of Practice in the Department of Laboratory Medicine and Pathology at Mayo Clinic. Did you know that aside from non-melanoma skin cancer, prostate cancer is the most common type of cancer among men in the United States? Well, because of the significance of the disease, we need to have a good understanding for how to screen for this disease. And in this month's hot topic, my colleague, Dr. Alicia Algeciras, will provide you with valuable information regarding the clinical utility of the prostate-specific antigen test and how the calculation of a prostate health index, or PHI, can help to stratify a patient's risk for developing prostate cancer and help to reduce unnecessary biopsies. I hope you enjoy this month's hot topic, and I want to personally thank you for allowing Mayo Clinic the opportunity to partner in your patient's healthcare.
Thank you, Dr. Binneker, for the introduction. My name is Alicia Algeciras Simnich. I am Associate Professor of Laboratory Medicine and Pathology and serve as Chair of the Clinical Biochemistry and Immunology Division at Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. I have received financial compensation from Beckman Coulter for speaking engagements. Utilization management is becoming increasingly relevant for most medical institutions. While viewing this presentation, take some time to consider a few points, including how this testing might be used in your practice, when should the test be ordered, and how the results from this testing might impact patient management. Other than skin cancer, prostate cancer is the most common type of cancer found in men in the United States. In 2017, the American Cancer Society estimates that 161,000 new cases of prostate cancer will be diagnosed. Prostate cancer is the third leading cause of cancer death in American men behind lung cancer and colorectal cancer, with an estimate of 26,000 deaths in 2017. Although prostate cancer could be a serious disease, most men diagnosed with prostate cancer will not die from the disease. Currently, more than 2.9 million men in the U.S. who have been diagnosed with prostate cancer at some point of their lives are still alive. The advances in prostate cancer diagnosis could be in part attributed to the discovery of prostate-specific antigen, or PSA, in the 1970s. In the 1980s, PSA was FDA-approved for monitoring of patients diagnosed with prostate cancer. Later, it was approved for the detection of prostate cancer and introduced as a screening tool for prostate cancer. This led to a dramatic increase in the incident rates for prostate cancer, driven by the widespread use of PSA. Overall, the early detection of prostate cancer has led to a decrease in prostate cancer mortality. Today, the mortality rate for prostate cancer is approximately 45% lower than in 1992. Today, the use of PSA for prostate cancer screening is highly controversial due to the limitations of PSA. Particularly, PSA has a modest sensitivity and low specificity for prostate cancer. For example, the specificity of PSA has been reported to be as low as 6% at a sensitivity of 95%. An elevated PSA might not be indicative of clinically significant cancer. The most common cause of slight elevations of PSA is benign prostatic hyperplasia, or BPH. The incidence of BPH increases with age. It is estimated that approximately 25% of 40-year-old men and 80% of 80-year-old men have BPH. The distinction between malignant and benign disease is particularly challenging in the total PSA range of 2 to 10 nanograms per milliliter, where there is a significant overlap between men with benign and malignant conditions. The low specificity of PSA has led to overdiagnosis of indolent disease and overtreatment, resulting in a high cost to manage patients with an elevated PSA. A study that evaluated the cost of PSA screening in the U.S. estimated that the average annual cost to Medicare in 2009 were approximately $500 million. 72% of the screening costs were related to downstream biopsy procedures, with the prostate cancer positive rate on the biopsy ranging from 22 to 40%. Research efforts has been directed at how can we make PSA a better cancer detection tool. PSA can be found in circulation as various isoforms. Total PSA immunoassays detect the PSA bound to alpha-1 antichemotrypsin as well as the free form of PSA. Within the free PSA fraction, there are multiple isoforms, including the precursor of PSA. The -7 pro-PSA represents the native precursor of PSA, where the -4 and -2 pro-PSA represent truncated forms of the -7 pro-PSA. In prostate cancer, elevated concentrations of the -2 pro-PSA have been described. For many years, laboratories have offered the free PSA test to help refine a man's risk for prostate cancer. Men with prostate cancer have a lower percent free PSA when compared to men with benign conditions. When the percent free PSA is less than 10%, the probability of cancer is around 56%, whereas percent free PSA values greater than 25% represent a probability of cancer of about 8%. Percent free PSA has been used to improve the sensitivity and specificity of PSA in men with a PSA between 4 to 10 nanograms per milliliter. As I previously mentioned, the free PSA isoform that has been shown to be elevated in prostate cancer is P2 PSA. P2 PSA has been shown to have higher specificity than total PSA and free PSA for prostate cancer detection. Moreover, the higher the level of P2 PSA, the higher the probability of finding high-grade prostate cancer as defined by a Gleason score equal or greater to 7. Clinically, P2 PSA has been incorporated into the Prostate Health Index, or PHI. This is a mathematical formula that combines the results of total PSA, free PSA, and P2 PSA to generate a score that represents the probability of detecting prostate cancer at the time of the biopsy. The higher the score, the greater the probability of finding clinically significant disease. A PHI range between 0 and 26.9 correspond to a probability of cancer of approximately 10%, while a PHI score greater than 55 corresponds to a 50% probability of finding cancer upon biopsy. PHI has a higher specificity than total P2 PSA and the percent free PSA. This table summarizes the results of a study that included 658 men with a total PSA between 4 and 10 nanograms per milliliter and a normal DRE. 49% of patients included in the study had prostate cancer on biopsy. This table shows the specificity of each marker for all prostate cancer and high-grade prostate cancer. The cutoff for each marker was selected to provide a 90% sensitivity, meaning that 10% of cancers will be missed. Using this cutoff, PHI show a specificity of 30%, which indicate that 30% of men with an elevated PSA in the 4 to 10 nanogram per milliliter range, but with benign disease, will have been spared from a biopsy. This will be the case for both all prostate cancer and men with significant prostate cancer. For comparison, 20% of cases will have been spared using percent free PSA. Overall, PHI provides superior diagnostic accuracy and better risk stratification than total PSA or percentage free PSA, as shown by ROC curve analysis. At a 95% sensitivity, using PHI for risk stratification will result in an improvement in the number of men with benign disease that will be spared from a biopsy. PHI specificity at 95% sensitivity was 16% compared to 7 and 8% for total PSA and percent free PSA, respectively. A meta-analysis published in 2014 evaluated the ability of percent P2 PSA and PHI to discriminate between aggressive and non-aggressive prostate cancer. Over 1,000 cases of prostate cancer were included in the analysis, with 431 cases having a Gleason score greater or equal to 7. The pool sensitivity for the detection of prostate cancer with higher Gleason score was 90%, while the specificity was 17% and a diagnostic odd ratio of 3.1. In clinical practice, PHI could be used to fill the diagnostic gap between PSA screening and a prostate biopsy. Combined with family and patient history, PHI can be used to tailor an individualized patient management plan. If the clinician determines that based on PHI and other risk factors, there is a low probability of finding prostate cancer upon biopsy, a patient may be monitored closely instead of having a biopsy. On the other hand, if the clinician determines that there is a higher probability of finding cancer, the patient will likely undergo a prostate biopsy. During this presentation, I also want to discuss other commercially available biomarkers that could fill the same diagnostic gap as PHI. The prostate cancer antigen 3, or PCA3 assay, is an urine test for a non-cutting prostate-specific mRNA that is overexpressed in prostate cancer cells. The reported result is a score based on the levels of PCA3 mRNA normalized to PSA mRNA to account for the number of prostate cells present in the urine. It is important that prior to the urine collection, the patient undergoes a rigorous prostate massage to release a sufficient number of prostate cells into the urine. The 4K score is a blood test that measures the serum levels of four biochemical markers: total PSA, free PSA, intact PSA, and human kallikrein 2. The assay incorporates the results of this test into a proprietary algorithm that also takes into account the patient age, whether nodules were detected during the DRE, and whether the patient had a prior negative biopsy. The score provides the probability of finding high-grade cancer upon biopsy, and similar to PHI, could help in the clinical decision on whether to proceed to a prostate biopsy. A limited number of studies are available comparing PHI to PCA3 and/or the 4K score. In the case of PHI to PCA3 comparison, two published studies have demonstrated similar performance between assays. The first study included 110 prostate cancer cases and showed that PCA3 had a slightly higher diagnostic accuracy and specificity. The men included in the study had an initial PSA concentration between 0.5 and 20 nanograms per mil, which is a wider range than what is considered the PSA diagnostic gray zone. The second study focused on the PSA diagnostic gray zone and included 108 prostate cancer cases. In this study, both assays show similar performance with a specificity of 40% at 90% sensitivity. It is important to note that the FDA-approved indication of this test is different. While PHI is FDA-approved in men that haven't had a prostate biopsy, PSA3 is indicated for men who had one or more negative prostate biopsies and a repeat biopsy is being considered. Comparison between the 4K score and PHI was performed in a cohort of 531 men, of which 271 were diagnosed with prostate cancer. Men had a total PSA between 3 and 15 nanograms per mil and were undergoing a prostate biopsy for the first time. Similar ROC area under the curve were found for PHI and 4K score regardless of whether all cases or only high-grade cancers were considered. Both assays showed superior performance than total PSA. Using a cutoff of 10% for 4K score and 39% for PHI as predictors for prostate cancer will have prevented 29% of biopsy on men with benign disease at a cost of delaying the diagnosis of 15% of men with prostate cancer and 10% of men with high-grade cancers. This study showed that both tests perform similarly and could both aid in the decision-making as to whether to proceed with the prostate biopsy. This is in alignment with the National Comprehensive Cancer Network guidelines for prostate cancer early detection. Given that between 30 to 35% of men with a total PSA between 4 and 10 nanograms per mil will be found to have cancer, patients with a PSA on this range will benefit from additional follow-up. The percentage-free PSA, PHI, or 4K score are not recommended as first-line screening tests. However, in cases where the PSA levels might indicate the need for a prostate biopsy, the use of these tests could be considered to further refine the probability of finding prostate cancer at the time of the biopsy. When you order PHI through Mayo Medical Laboratories, testing starts with measurement of total PSA. In order to promote proper ordering and utilization of PHI, the other two tests required for the PHI calculation will only be performed when the total PSA is between 2 and 10 nanograms per milliliter. As shown in this flowchart, if total PSA is less than 2 or greater than 10 nanograms per milliliter, no further testing will be performed. If the total PSA is between 2 and 10 nanograms per milliliter, then free PSA and P2 PSA will be performed. The percent free PSA and PHI are calculated only in those cases with a PSA between 4 and 10, which is the concentration range where the percent free PSA and PHI are most clinically useful. This is a sample report for PHI. When total PSA is between 4 and 10 nanograms per milliliter, the total PSA, free PSA, and the P2 PSA will be measured and reported. Flagging will be performed for only the total PSA portion of the test. For percent free PSA and PHI, an interpretation table is provided for the clinician to assess the probability of finding prostate cancer at the time of biopsy based on the obtained score. To summarize, PHI is a blood test for prostate cancer risk assessment. It is currently FDA approved and recommended by the NCCN guidelines for prostate cancer early detection as a tool to further refine the probability of finding cancer upon biopsy in men with an elevated PSA. If used in the right population, it could avoid approximately 30% of unnecessary biopsies. PHI is indicated in men with a total PSA between 4 and 10 nanogram per milliliter and prior to performing a prostate biopsy. Finally, multiple studies have demonstrated a superior diagnostic accuracy for PHI when compared to total PSA and percent free PSA.